So how can a company or business find out the customers who are likely to cancel their subscription or service in the near future? It's very important to find that out, otherwise a company may get a revenue hit, especially if they are in a subscription business. Folks, Nitin here, and this is the AI University channel. In this video and onwards, we are going to start a new project where we will try to predict the customers who are likely to churn out or leave a company or business. It's going to be a predictive model where we will cover all the aspects of data science lifecycle to clean the data, perform exploratory data analysis, build several models like k-nearest neighbor, support vector machines, logistic regression, decision tree, random forest, etc. Evaluate a model, shortlist a model who is giving the better accuracy, and lastly, finding out the probability of customers getting churned out. We will also create a visualization wherever required. So watch this video till the end. If you are new here, then consider subscribing to this channel, or if you have already subscribed, then click on the bell icon to receive the notifications about hottest technologies of 21st century. GitHub link for all the required Jupyter notebooks is given in the description section as well as at the end of the video. Please don't forget to like and share this video. Let's first understand the meaning of churn prediction. Well, churn prediction is a technique using which we can detect the customers who are likely to cancel subscription or service. Now, there are three ways using which businesses can generate more revenue. Number one, upsell to existing customers. Number two, acquire new customers. And number three, increase customer retention. Churn prediction helps in focusing on number three point of the customer retention, where we either try to reduce the customer retention efforts on customers who we predict that they may churn out in near future, or we may take proactive action to make them stay with the business. So as far as this project is concerned, we are trying to find out the customers who may churn out, so businesses can then engage with these customers to offer them some rewards or incentives to stay with businesses longer. You can also take feedback from these customers to understand if they are not liking any specific product or services, so that you can offer relatively better product or service in the near future. This is a very good strategy to keep your customer stick with you for a longer period of time. Let's move on to the data set we are going to basically use to build this model. So we will use this telecom customer churn data set here. So there are 7,043 records in this data set, and it has 21 columns or features as well. So you can see that there are these features like customer ID, gender, senior citizen, partner, dependents, etc. So there are overall 21 such features on the basis of which we are going to build our churn prediction model. So let's head over to Jupyter Notebook real quick, where we have written some Python code. So in the first cell, I'm trying to import necessary libraries like NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib, Seaborn, and Pandas profiling. Most of us already know the usage of Pandas, NumPy, and Matplotlib, and Seaborn is another visualization library here. Pandas profiling is a library using which you can get the details like missing values, unique values, data type of each columns, quantiles, interquantile range, minimum value, maximum value, mean, median, kurtosis, skewness, correlations, etc. in one go in the form of HTML report using just one line of code. You need to first install a package called Pandas profiling. So you can either use pip install pandas hyphen profiling command, or you can use conda install hyphen c conda hyphen forge pandas hyphen profiling to install this package. I have already installed it on my system. Please note that I have created a separate video on this topic to explain each and every component associated with this pandas profiling report. So you can watch that video by clicking on the I button above. So in the next cell, I'm invoking this pandas profiling package and utilizing its profile report method to generate the report. Inside this method, I'm passing pd.read_csv and name of our customer churn dataset as an argument. You could see that it has generated the report giving you dataset info like number of variables, number of observations, missing values, etc. So when we ran the cell, we got this pandas profiling report. We can see that this data set has 21 number of variables, number of observations are 7043, and it doesn't contain any missing values. Also, there are two numerical variables, as you can see on the right hand side. So there are two numerical variables, 12 categorical variables and 6 boolean variables. So if you scroll down, you will find the info about each individual variable. So you can see that there is a variable called churn, which is our target variable. It has the values no and yes, then the count of those observations. If you scroll down further, you will see the correlation between important numerical variables. Okay, so you can get a lot of information from this particular report. In the next cell, I'm reading the customer churn dataset by making use of pandas read underscore CSV method and by passing customer churn dataset CSV file as an argument. In the next line, I'm showing you how you can check the dimensions, that is number of rows and columns of a dataset separately. Although profile report above includes this information as well. So I have used this shape method here, okay, using which you can find the dimensions of a data set. In the next cell, I am doing some data manipulation on our target variable called churn. If you notice, it has two string values such as yes and no. Yes depicts that customer will churn out and no means that he or she won't be churning out. Since these are string values, so we need to convert them to numeric values because our machine learning model understands the data in numeric form only. So here in this cell, I am converting value no to 0 and value yes to 1. Now there are 6 columns, namely online backup, streaming movies, device protection, tech support, online security, streaming TV, which has values like no, yes and no internet service. Since value no and value no internet service is just like one and same thing, so we are converting value no internet service to value no in order to be consistent. But if you want, you can keep them separate as well. So in the next cell, we are first creating the list of columns that possess these values. Okay, and that list name is cols, C-O-L-S. In the next line, we are using a for loop to pick each column one by one from the list called cols, and then applying method called replace to replace no internet service with no. Now moving on to the next cell, the column called total charges is shown as categorical in our profile report. So you can see that total charges is shown as categorical here. So this column called total charges is shown as categorical in our profile report, but it contains some float values. So what do we need to do here? Well, we need to change the data type of this column to float. This is because we need to have data in right form with consistent data type. So in the next cell, we are doing that only. First, we are replacing all the spaces with null values using replace method, which has two parameters. First parameter represents space in inverted commas, and second one is NaN or not a number representing null value. In the next line, we are dropping these null values. Then in the next line, we are converting these categorical values into float type by making use of as type method and passing float as parameter inside this method. Now, since we are done with required data manipulation here, we will now do some visualization to explore our data. So in the next cell, which is this cell, we are visualizing total customer churn. We can see that 26.6% customers got churned out and remaining 73.4% customers were still loyal with the company and hence didn't churn. So here we are first extracting key values, which are nothing but denotes the churn values 0 and 1. These values are stored in a variable called plot underscore by underscore churn underscore labels. Next, we are calculating corresponding count values. These values are stored in variable called plot by churn values. Then we are defining parameters for pie chart, and this pie chart is associated with our plotly.graph_objs package, which we named as go or go. So we are defining its labels, values, color of pie chart, which is teal and gray, rotation as 90, hover info, which gets visible when you hover over your mouse on the pie chart, plot layout, which contains title, background, color, etc. Then we are plotting this pie chart using plotly.offline package, which is depicted as PO here. So when we ran the cell, we got this pie chart here. And if you hover over it, you will see the values, corresponding values. Then we wanted to see the churn rate for gender male and female. Hence, we created this bar plot in the next cell. First, we grouped the data based on column gender and then calculated the mean value for both male and female, and then plotted the bar plot by keeping gender on x-axis and churn rate values on y-axis. Width for the individual plot was kept as 0.03, and the width is this width. And the colors were chosen as green and orange for these bar plots. In the plot layout, we defined x-axis and y-axis parameters. So x-axis parameter was type category and y-axis parameter was title churn rate. Now the title of the plot was kept as churn rate by gender, and then we defined the background color, etc. Then we are plotting this bar plot using plotly.offline package, which is depicted as PO here again. So we can see that the churn rate for female was slightly more than the churn rate of male. Similarly, we created the bar plot for churn rate by tech support in the next cell. We could see that customers who don't contact tech support are more likely to churn. In the next cell, we created the bar plot for churn rate by internet services. We could see that the customers who had fiber optics as internet service were more likely to churn. And reason of that could be the competition or price, etc. In the next cell, we created the bar plot for churn rate by payment method. And we could see that customers making payment through electronic checks were more likely to churn. In the next cell, we created the bar plot for churn rate by contract duration. We could see that customers with shorter duration of contract were more likely to churn. So customers who had longer contract duration, like 2 years, were less likely to churn. In the next cell, we created the scatter plot between churn rate and numerical variable tenure. We could see that higher tenure resulted in low churn rate. If you want to create beautiful dynamic dashboards with HTML elements like button, radio button, slider, dropdown, etc. using Python instead of just standalone graphs, then you can watch this video series, a link of which is given in the I button above and description section of this video. Now there are certain categorical and Boolean variables in the dataset for which we need to do one-hot encoding, so that our machine learning model can interpret these values in an optimum way. You can watch this video to learn more about one-hot encoding in detail. Link of this video is provided both in I button as well as in the description section of this video. Now, as mentioned earlier, without converting these categorical features into dummy variables, our machine learning model won't be able to infer them as possible inputs for model training. So in the next cell, I'm making use of get_dummies method of pandas to convert categorical features into dummy variables. This method has three arguments. Number one is the data set containing names of the columns on which we want to perform one-hot encoding, which in our case is churn_dataset. Second argument is the list of categorical and Boolean column names that we want to convert. So I have given that list here. And the third argument was drop_first=true. By keeping these parameters as true, we drop the first column. This is because one column indicates the value of the other column. For example, gender column has two values, male and female. If the male has value 1, then the female will be 0, and vice versa. So if you remove male, then the value of female will suffice, and that's why we are keeping the drop underscore first as true here. Please note that we can't keep all the dummy variables in our model, because then it will result in a multicollinearity situation. So whenever you are building any model and you have created certain dummy variables, then always omit one dummy variable from it. If let's say there are three dummy variables, then omit one and keep rest of the two. So folks, this is it for this video. In the next upcoming videos, I will cover remaining Python coding steps to build, train and evaluate various machine learning models to shortlist the one who is giving better accuracy. So here is today's question. State true or false. Get underscore dummies method helps finding out the one hot encoding of the categorical variables. Please post your answers, comments in the comment section given below so that I can get a chance to incorporate your feedback. You can also post your technical questions in the comment section and I will try to answer the same. If you are watching this video and you are not already a subscriber to our channel, consider clicking that little subscribe button. In case you have already subscribed, then click on the bell icon to receive the notifications whenever I will release a new video. So thanks for hanging out with me guys. I will be covering next topic in the upcoming video. So keep on watching. Thank you.